Hello and welcome back to Excelsif. If you have watched my last video about basic Excel shortcuts for beginners and are hungry for more, you are in the right place. Today, I am going to show you the best advanced Excel keyboard shortcuts, tips and tricks, but I got so many to share with you that putting them all in just one video would have made the video a lot longer. So I've divided this one into two parts. Let's begin with the first one. Just like the last time, we are going to work in this sheet to demonstrate today's Excel shortcuts. And I have divided them into the same categories like the last time. Cell contents, cell formatting, formulae, and navigation. And just like the last time, I have prepared a PDF with all the advanced shortcuts for Excel, which you can download for free. You'll get the link in the description and the QR code in the next video. Let's start with our first category. First up, inserting a forced line break. Let's say we need to write our contact person in here. We can write it by adding a whole new column, but let's consider that we need to mention it right under the client name. Maybe that will look better when this page is printed. To do that, we can put a line break. How do you normally put a line break? When you are working in MS Word or typing an email, you press Enter, right? That wouldn't work in Excel. Instead, we have to go to edit the cell, which you can do either by double clicking on the cell or clicking in the formula bar here, or simply press F2 on your keyboard and here we are. Now press Alt and Enter and we have a line break. Let's write our contact person here, John Doe, and press Enter. Excel automatically expands the row height to fit this new entry, which let me remind you is still in the cell B5. You have a client folder where you have all the files of all these clients and you want to link the client name to its relevant folder. To achieve this, we can insert a hyperlink here by pressing Ctrl and K, which brings up this menu, and from here, you can select your folder or maybe a web address or an email. We frequently have to pull up the Paste Special menu, and there are not one but two shortcuts for that. You can bring the Paste Special dialog by pressing Alt, E and S. And the second keyboard shortcut to bring the same menu is Ctrl, Alt, and V. Personally, I think Ctrl, Alt, and V is easy to remember since we are already accustomed to using Ctrl, V to paste anyways. Incidentally, if you're simply using Paste Special Dialog to paste as values, do this instead. In our rating column, we have our nested if formula. Let's say we have to convert this to values. So, we copy it first by Ctrl-C as usual and then press Ctrl-Shift-V to paste it as values. In our last video about basic shortcuts, if we had to do a fill color, we had to go up here. Instead, you can use Alt-H and H to bring up the fill menu. Then use your arrow keys to get the fill color you want. You can also remove fill color from here. Let's say we need to remove the fill color from this column here, B2. So we get here and press Alt-H-H. And you see this option where it says no fill and has N on top of it. If you press N on your keyboard, there won't be any fill color. Or you can press M to go to more colors. Have you ever used the notes feature in Excel? It's a pretty decent feature and quite useful too. If you wish to put a note in a cell, use Shift F2 and you get this sticky note dialog box. Type what you want here. You can drag it or resize it by dragging it from here. Once you're done, press Escape to hide it and it won't come up until you hover your mouse on this cell here. Notes are basically useful in cases when a single person is using a file. But when you have your colleagues working on the same file, there's a better feature called Threaded Comments. To bring it up, press Ctrl, Shift and F2 and you get this. You can write your comment here, check this and press Ctrl, Enter to post it. Now someone can reply to this comment here and it will come up like a chat window, which is pretty neat. I just noticed I have misspelled the spelling in here, B1. I seem to have messed up with the word report. Let's fix that. Press F7 and what have we here? A spell check in Excel? I bet you didn't know that, did you? We click on change here and move on our merry way. Let's say we have to bring our rating from the last column in this data to right next to our client name. We can copy this column, then insert a column next to our client name and paste it there. Then we'll have to come back and get rid of this rating column. But let's try something much better. Select the whole column, bring your mouse right at the edge, and it turns to this four arrow thingy. Now press and hold shift on the keyboard and drag it to here. Just mind this line that comes up. Once you have it like this, you can release the column. Like this, and it's done. If that line is something like this, that will remove the column underneath and put the rating column there. So in other words, you can insert and replace columns with this shortcut. First up in our cell formatting category, applying borders, but not like the last time. We tried outline border in our last video with the shortcut Ctrl Shift and ampersand, but that was a basic keyboard shortcut and we are in the big leagues now. We need the whole menu this time, not just the outline border. So let's select our whole range first, like this, and now press Alt, H and B, and we have the full borders menu at our disposal. All we have to do is press the corresponding letter. I'm going with A for all borders, and here we have our borders. Similarly, if you wish to change font or size, make yourself bold or italic, press Ctrl, Shift and F to get to the font tab in the Format Cells dialog. You can also get to the Format Cells dialog by pressing Ctrl 1, but Ctrl, Shift, F takes you directly to the Fonts tab. There are a couple of more keyboard shortcuts in Excel with Ctrl and Shift combination. Let's start with our first column, Date. Clearly, it can't be understood as a date in its current form until we change it to the date format. To do just that, we're going to select it with Ctrl, Shift and down arrow and press Ctrl, Shift and hash to convert it to date format. Just like the date format, we have one for the time format too. Select the cell and press Ctrl, Shift and number 2, which also has the @ symbol on it, and it's converted to time. Our sales figures are not in currency format, so select them all and press Ctrl, Shift and the dollar symbol or the key 4 on your keyboard. Depending on where you are, you may not have the dollar symbol on your number 4 key, but it'll work the same. You'll get the currency symbol here as per your system settings though. Our ratings don't look like numbers, so select them all and press Ctrl, Shift and number 1 with the exclamation symbol, and we have them as numbers. We have one for percentage format as well. We don't have any field here for percentage, so let's quickly create one here. We'll call it percentage of total. Let's write our simple formula here. Our sales for a client divided by a total down here, and we'll press F4 on our total to fix it. Done. Now press Ctrl, Shift and percentage symbol, which is on number 5. Wait, this can't be right. All of my figures are in whole numbers, which is not plausible. The easiest way to check this sort of situation is to check the total of the column. It should add up to 100%. So while we have it selected, check at the bottom. It does say 100%, but let's make it a bit more accurate. Press Ctrl 1 to get to the Format Cells dialog and get some decimal places here. Let's make it 3. Now it's better. Sometimes our data is not properly formatted and looks like this. You may know to auto-fit them, we need to simply double-click on the edge of the column. Bring your mouse here, and when it changes to this, double-click and it will auto-size to fit the longest item in that column. But if you have a large data set, you can't be doing this for all columns. Instead, you can click on here to select the whole sheet and then double-click on the edge of any column like before. Or you can use the keyboard shortcut. That'll do that for you. Select your data like this, press Alt, H, O, I, and it's done. When your data is not in a table and has many, many rows and you scroll down, you can't see the headers row, and the easy fix for this issue is to freeze the top row. Get to the top of your data, press Alt, W, F, R, and now when you scroll down, you can still see the headers. When you want to unfreeze it, press Alt-WFF and it's done. Last in this category and today's video is actually a Swiss knife of shortcuts. Let me first select one column. Let's select this one here, the sales column. If you press Ctrl-Q, we get to this menu and you have all these tabs up top. Look at the options you have with just one keyboard shortcut. You can have data bars from here. You can highlight cells which are greater than a certain number. You can highlight the top 10%, insert charts like this, totals, pivot tables, and sparklines. I told you this one is like a Swiss Army knife of shortcuts. And with that, we have reached at the end of this video, and I'll see you in the next part of this video where I have advanced Excel shortcuts from the formulae and the navigation categories. So if you haven't subscribed already, do it now, share and comment on this video to let me know your feedback and help the channel while doing so. Until next time, happy spreadsheeting.